Machine. Charlie Bates rides in fourth, and then it is the number 20 of David Bullington in fifth. Chris Rickett once again powering out to the lead. Gary Blanken trying to stay right there with him, just about four car lengths back as they come off a four. Now Rickett widens the gap. Gary Blanken right there. Then the Bill Curl in the 57. About four car lengths behind the number five of Blanken. Charlie Bates rides in the number four spot. Chris Rickett goes in the pits. Gary Blanken inherits the lead. Gary Blanken now leads. Bill Curl in the 57 rides in the number two spot. Charlie Bates is third. Now the number 20 of David Bullington is fourth. And it looks like the number 36 actually, I believe it's going to be the number four of Jeffrey Milton that's going to be in fifth place. White flag is out. Race winners, race re-leader coming off of turn two. And it looks like it's going to be the number five of Gary Blanken. Gary Blanken is going to take the checkered flag. Gary Blanken. Bill Curl will grab second place and the number 27. Charlie Bates takes third. Y'all give a big round of applause. Gary Blanken. Gary, I tell you what, he's running hard, running good from the start. Chris Rickett jumped out a pretty good lead there in front of you. Stayed out front. What happened? I seen him all of a sudden just go into the pits.
I don't know what happened to him. I seen back there on the back straightaway, he wiggled real bad and then cut to the bottom. So I don't know what let go on it or something. But that's the only way I was going to win tonight. I ain't hardly got enough to run with him, but... We didn't go to Tazewell tonight because they was having a big one over there, and I know that'd be about fifth over there probably.
I'll tell you what. Now, you had a guy coming up on you on the backside, Bill Curl, in that number 57. He started seventh. He worked his way up through the pack fast, and then he got right up there in that third-place spot before Chris Rickett jumped on the jumped down into the pits there, and he was coming on you pretty hard. He stayed on you pretty hard.
Well, if you notice, this thing's pushing. Every race this year, we've had tight problems. And we figured out the rear end housing's bent. We're going to have to pull it out and change it or straighten it or something. I've changed everything out of the car the last few weeks. Nothing's helped. It pushes going in the corner, and I have to wait on it to get back in the throttle about the middle of the corner. So I can't – I mean, that's getting me behind right off the bat. But I managed tonight and just – I mean, a little bit of luck. That's the only way I won this one tonight. But thank the good Lord, I mean, I'll take it.
Absolutely a tough break for Chris Rickett on that, having to go inside. But you got the checkered flag. Who would you like to thank tonight?
I don't think Frankie owns this car, and Chuck and Johnny works on it all the time. They work on it and try to keep it going as good as we can. And it pays off sometimes, did tonight. And I also want to thank old Travis Fultz. He builds a good motor for this old car. And I mean, we ain't got the biggest one, but it's still a good motor. It'll halfway keep up.
Absolutely right. It got you into checkers tonight, so congratulations.
I appreciate it. I want to thank everybody that hung around to watch that.
Fantastic. Y'all give one more big round of applause. Gary Blanken.